Conor, welcome to K-Park. What are your thoughts on joining the club?
An exciting time, to be honest. I'm really looking forward to getting going and looking forward to the challenge ahead. It's something new for me, so I just want to get tore right into it.
It's a long time since football was last played competitively outside of the Scottish Premiership. What have you been doing during the lockdown period and how have you been staying in shape?
To be honest, I've actually used the time just to wind down as well. I think that's important for the lads to mentally just switch off and enjoy time with their friends and family. But you know, as the dates came out for the when we thought football would return, then it's maybe time to get the legs going again and keep ticking over. I'm actually quite fortunate with my job that I'm involved in football outside of playing, so I kept in shape through using the programs that were put in place from the Rangers Academy. So. That's been ideal for me. They keep me ticking over really, so that's about it.
Tell us a little bit more about your job at the Rangers Academy and how do you manage to juggle the coaching side and the playing side?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just going into my third season now working with Rangers. My second season now full time with them. My role is under 18 goalkeeper coach. It's something I really enjoy and I've got a great passion for. So I manage to get that balance while I'm playing part time and coaching full time. So. I'm obviously involved a lot with the ball during the week, which helps me then bring into my own game. And also the fact that I'm coaching, I think, helps me when I'm playing that. Even when I'm going on the coaching courses and doing the A license and things like that, it probably helps me identify things in the game a lot quicker, which then I can bring into my own game. So I've got that good balance of coaching and playing, and that's a great place to work, and the club's been brilliant with me.
You've come to the club at the same time as your former Dumbarton teammate, Kyle Hutton. How big an influence was Kyle on the team at Dumbarton and what do you think he'll bring to his club?
Yeah, of course, he's obviously a really experienced player in terms of his background and playing at Rangers and different things like that. But you know, playing behind Kyle, he's got that experience and he's got a good balance of going forward and sitting at the back. So what he'll bring to the team is I think he'll bring enthusiasm. He's obviously a good leader. He is getting on a bit now, so I don't know how his legs will hold up, but fingers crossed.
And what are you expecting for the season ahead in the Women's League?
I think it's no secret about what the club want to achieve and where they want to go going forward. I mean, everybody that's involved in Scottish football probably have heard what East Kilbride want to do, and it's really, really exciting. I think the main goal and the objective is it needs to be promotion. Obviously, we know that the claim isn't one on paper, but it's about putting that foundation in and trying to kick on from there. So it's a really, really exciting time for the club.
What can the K-Park crowd expect from you once the season gets started?
Obviously I'm looking forward to get going first and foremost. It's a new challenge for me from an individual point of view, but you know, I'm 26 now, so I'm at that stage where I would like to think that I'm getting a wee bit more experienced. I played every game for Dumbarton last season in League One, so it's obviously a good level and a good standard. So what they expect from me is hopefully consistency first and foremost is what I want to bring to the club. And then try and gel together as a team and really start pushing up the league and try and get promotion.